Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Ten's coverage of the 1984 Escort Cup and the grand final this evening, with Sturt taking on South Adelaide. Again, conditions are ideal for night football, and a good crowd is on hand to witness this first night grand final at Footy Park. Let's now go down to the Panthers' dressing rooms, and it's Brenton Miles talking with Graham Corns.
Graham, congratulations on making yet another grand final in a night series competition. South making a habit of this over recent years. Is there any particular feature of your style of play that that helped you do so well in night football?
Strange enough, Brent, we've had to play six games to get here tonight. Only two of them have been night games, but I know what you're saying, because in previous years, South have really established a good reputation as night footballers. And I think it goes back to Hayden Bunton's days, where he relied on a small running team that could get the hard ball. And, you know, a lot of the game is played on the ground at night. Probably not quite so much here at Football Park, because the lights are so good. But as soon as a team establishes a reputation, such as South have got, you become very proud of it. And of course, the players' confidence lifts with that, and it sort of builds on itself more than anything. But we made the grand final last year, and we were beaten by West Torrens, who are not a team of renown for night football. So really, there's no real key to it, other than the fact that we've had good success over the years, and probably that's help the players' mental attitude more than anything. Yeah.
What particular things will you be emphasising tonight? Obviously, a couple of the things you've mentioned about tradition of doing well in night series and confidence in the ball on the ground. What other things will you emphasise tonight?
Well, we're very much aware of the fact that we were disappointing last year when we were favourites for the grand final and West Torrens beat us at Theverton. And probably my main thrust of emphasis will be that unless you prepared to go out and play the game to its fullest, the team that settles down quickly, of course, will be the team that gets away to a good start. But the main emphasis is that Sturt are a very good team if you let them. They haven't enjoyed good success over the past couple of weeks, but there's not to say they haven't got players capable of playing very good football, and we want to be very much aware of that. We want to be very much aware of the fact that we were disappointing last year, and as you mentioned before, the tradition that South Adelaide has got in night football is there to be upheld.
Well, Graham, we do wish you well. You've had a fine season and a great season as coach, and we wish you all the very best for tonight's game.
Thanks.
Good luck.
And South Adelaide from the forward line: Slattery, Harris, Irvine. The half forwards: Hewitt, Schneebickler, David Kapler, Darren Kapler, Allen, Butler, Glenn Hewitt, McIntyre, White, Bennett, Brooksby and Palmer. And the rucks are Christie, Fairclough and Naylor. The Double Blues' performance during the last few weeks has been up and down, but tonight they have a chance to at least win the night grand final. Again down to Brenton Miles, and this time he's talking to Sturt's John McInnes.
John, a disappointing season for you really, but nevertheless your form in the semi-final of the Escort Cup must have give you some real confidence for tonight's grand final.
Yes, against Glenelg they played very, very well. They were at the ball, they were aggressive, and they used a lot of teamwork, the form that perhaps we haven't displayed on the round and round games over the last few weeks.
Yeah. And I noticed Frank Spiel, who played so well in that semi-final, is playing at centre-half back again tonight, obviously on John Schneebickler. You'd be hoping for a like performance from him again tonight.
Yes, against young Kernahan, he played a very disciplined game. He was able to stay with him and spoil him and keep him from being that dominating force that he usually is in those matches. So tonight, on John Schneebickler, who is another creative player in the forwards, we've given Frank that job to be with him all night and to stay with him and perhaps to stop him from creating too many forward moves.
Good. And McPhee gets an opportunity tonight. He's obviously a very, very good young player.
Yes, Tim Paik dropped out through injury. He wasn't quite 100% fit, so Jamie McPhee gets his chance on the half-back flank. He's played extremely well in the last few reserve matches. Very aggressive, very talented player, and he certainly, with a youngster, gives us a little bit of go in the side.
John, we wish you well on your capacity tonight as caretaker coach. We wish the football club all the very best in tonight's grand final.
Right, good thanks luck. Very much, Brendan.
And there you can see the Sturt lineup. And firstly, the rucks: McCackney, Craig, Painter. From the forward line: Brown, Wilmot, Barbary, Benson, Motley, Smith. Across the centre: Wilson, Hutton, Radbone. The halfbacks: McPhee, Spiel, Fry. And the back line: Ford, Reed and Whittlesey. So there you have it. We'd also like to welcome viewers throughout Australia to this coverage of the Escort Cup. And right after this break, your commentators Ted Langridge, Brenton Miles and 5DN's Brian Cunningham. We'll be back shortly with the first bounce of the 1984 Escort Cup Grand Final.
Welcome back to Football Park for this grand final of the Escort Cup. And in the grand final of the Pizza Hut SANFL Cup played earlier this evening, Ross Trevor College had a good win over Unley High. Ross Trevor 11-9-75 defeated Unley High 4-6-30. Brian Cunningham, you might have some news on some late changes in the teams that you've just been notified of.
Yes, there have been some late changes, Ted. For South Adelaide, Phil Wald is out of the side and he's been replaced by Michael Irvine, who will take his place in the forward pocket and row with Mark Naley. Likewise, Sturt have a late change and Tim Paik on that half-back line has dropped out of the team and he'll be replaced by Jamie McPhee at half-back, and Shane Hewish will come in as an interchange player for Sturt. Brenton, I guess that Sturt will be looking for something like their semi-final effort against Glenelg tonight.
Well, there's no doubt about that, Brian, and I'm sure John McGuinness would have reminded his players time and time again tonight that they performed very well a fortnight ago in that semi-final competition. Interestingly enough, one of the players that was a real playmaker for Sturt that night and set the ball rolling from that defensive action time and time again was Tim Paik, and unfortunately for Sturt, he's pulled out through injury, as you've just mentioned. But a lot of interest will centre around his replacement, McPhee, because potentially he's apparently a very, very good player.
We see that Frank Spiel is playing at centre half back again, and he did a fine job 2 weeks ago against Glenelg and Stephen Kernahan.
Well, here it is. First bounce down of the Escort Cup Grand Final for 1984. Two young fellows in the centre, McKechnie and Christie. Christie's tap away. The ball with Snee Beckler. Kapler tries to burst through. Ruled that he's been held. First free kick of the game, and indeed the first kick will go the way of South Adelaide. David Kapler, just forward of the centre, uses his pace to gain some yardage. Wonderful kick down towards that forward area. Harris couldn't complete the mark. Sturt can't bring it away through Hewish. Hits the ground. The kick towards goal by Dawkins was bustled away. Wilson's there. Just taps it along the ground. Safety of the line. Throw in right forward pocket in the South Adelaide forward area.
Ray Wilson playing at centre wing. Now going back to that position, having come down from the half forward flank. Ball with Eddie Fryer. Hurried left foot kick is poor, but it comes out to Sturt. And they'll clear from that half back line. It's John Painter with the ball. Gets it up to centre wing. Christian McKechnie go for the ball, but the spoiler's on. No player gaining a clear possession there. In fact, the umpire's found a free. It's going the way of South Adelaide, and the free to be taken by Glenn Hewitt, who, of course, played very well for South Adelaide in their last Escort Cup encounter. A good kick, too. Good drop punt kick down towards the half-forward line. Players fall to the ground, but play on calls the umpire. Craig beautifully tackled there, and, in fact, is caught holding the ball by John Dawkins, and the South Adelaide forward on the half-flank with an opportunity to bring up South Adelaide's first score. Fair distance out, though, although he looks as though he's going to have that long shot from goal. Plenty of leads coming towards him, but he steadies, drives in long, doesn't get a lot of distance. Well sport there from the square area, but straight out towards a South Adelaide player there. And Kapler, he snaps back towards goal, but it's offline. And the first score, a minor one, a point to South Adelaide in the first 2 minutes of this first quarter. Sturt bringing the ball out to the outer side of the ground. The leads are on out there. Craig in front, but he won't go for it. He'll wait for the crumb. He's picked it up. It was sport by his own player. Keeps on battling in there and eventually wins a free. Eyes on the ball all the way. And it's Neil Craig with the ball on the half-back line for Sturt.
South Adelaide, the only score on the board, a point at this stage. Up towards Smith on the centre wing, but the ball fisted away from him by White. And a throw-in necessary outer side flank. Christie and McKechnie again. Neither ruckman gets a tap away. Smith tries to burst his way through, and it's ruled that he held the ball. Mark Naley to take the kick. He's on centre wing. South Adelaide into attack again. No breeze at all. The ball spoiled to the ground, but bustled away quickly there by Michael Irvine. His snap in towards goal goes too far. Out of bounds on the full, and the free kick will be taken by Reed of Sturt. Peter Reed's kick gets some distance towards that half-back flank. Oh, it's a fine mark to Snabikla. Ran with the run of the ball, didn't interfere, and took a very good mark indeed. The kick gets about 50 metres in towards goal, and Frank Spiel is there to take the mark. Or gets the hand pass away, loses about 50 yards to Painter. Painter's short kick has been marked by Greg Whittlesey across the half-back line. Waits too long. The good tackler's on. Wilson changes direction of play, once again around the wing, and the mark taken there by Benson. The hand pass back, oh, puts him into trouble. It's bad use of the ball by Sturt. Hewitt gives ground. He knocks it further. Glenn Hewitt, that is. He's tackled. Gets boot the ball or need a ball. Tapped away there for South by Stewie Palmer. The ball on the ground again. Players trying to go forward. They can't. Finally finishes with Naley again. Has Kapler running free, but goes for the long kick to half forward. McPhee in front. No, it's Ford in front to take the mark. Gary Ford. 15-metre penalty. No leads forthcoming, so he drives long into the Sturt half-forward area.
Motley up in front, but Palmer, the player from behind there, he's going to be awarded the mark. There's a kick off the ground by Craig. Whether or not he heard the umpire's whistle is anybody's guess, but nevertheless, a 15-metre penalty.
He heard the umpire's whistle, all right. There was no doubt he wanted to get back where the ball was going to fall, and that's what he's done.
Right, bit of experience there, certainly. The handball on to a teammate there in Butler. High kick towards centre-half forward, Eddie Fry. Good body work there, and nudges his opponent out of the road, wins the mark. Plays on very quickly, out of sight of the ground. There it's taken by Russell Hutton. Plays on quickly, the short kick across to Craig, and certainly
he covered some ground, didn't he?
He did, and looks to be full of enthusiasm tonight. The short kick, or relatively short kick, up towards the half forward line. It's going to come unstuck, though. The South Adelaide bring the ball out of defence with a series of handballs. A good long driving kick up towards centre half forward. Now, big pack of players there. Over the back it goes. The ever alert Wayne Slattery has one bounce. Now he'll steady and fire for goal. Good play there from Slattery. And in fact, he's going to bring up a goal. Some very good football there from South Adelaide. We'll get back here to comment on that in a moment. But the scores 1-1 South Adelaide. Sturt yet to score.
When South Adelaide move that ball, they move it so fluently. Here goes Wayne Slattery now reading the ball so well off the pack, as he so often does. Lines up the goals. He's a powerful kick for a little fella, and that's straight through the centre, and you can't let players like Slattery read the ball off hands like he did then. So a good goal, the first goal on the board to South Adelaide. 1-1 to Sturt, yet to score.
Once again, umpire Argent to get play in motion. 7 points to nil. The bounce. Keckney's tap, Craig, wild hand pass, finally finds its way into Barbary's hands. His kick wider, Wilson again into it. Left boot up forward, looks for the leader, Wilmot. The spoil is good. Brown's hand pass is good towards Motley. Has a player in the goal square, but well tackled and finally forced to punch the ball towards goal. That was Bennett, who was instrumental in that ball going down ground for South's goal, who put the good tackle on Motley. Not wearing a head guard tonight, I notice. Stewie Palmer to take the kick in. So Sturt trailed by a goal. Palmer's kick towards the outer side flank. Christie takes the mark. And a 15-metre penalty. Kick is long. Over the centre and towards half forward. Off the hands of Spiel. Hutton shows pace to get there. Quickly tackled. The hand pass well and truly smothered. Dawkins from centre half forward. In towards full forward. The good fist away works. And it's Whittlesey who brings it away. That's a better kick out of defence. Over towards the grandstand wing. First player there will be Benson. The two South players hotly in attack on the ball, and it's Glenn Hewitt, who punches it over the line. Would have liked to have kept it in play, but just couldn't. Left half forward flank for Sturt. They're kicking towards the northern end. Motley, who goes for the fist. Barbary, quickly to be tackled. Ducked under it. Umpire wisely let it go. Finishes with Naley. Naley bounces around centre wing. He's well shepherded. Well done, the young fellow McPhee came up, made him hurry the kick high in the air, forces the South forwards to go for the defensive action. The lad looked good then when he smothered that ball up, Jamie McPhee, Brian?
Yes, he's a good young player and shows a lot of promise. I think only 18 years of age, so he's got a big future at Sturt.
Snee Bickler from behind, taps it over the back, but Craig waiting for it there. Kick straight across the ground, but perfect accuracy. Finds Eddie Fry. Eddie Fry up towards centre wing, but South Adelaide there. South Adelaide player and Robin White holds that play for Sturt there at centre wing. Kick down is in the direction of Eddie Fry, but the fist is on there from Kapler. Spoils Eddie Fry, and this allows Sturt in through Ford. South Adelaide being tackled there by two Sturt players, and Gary Ford will come out with the free on the half-back line for Sturt. Ford's kick underway. Two Sturt players there. Neither can take the mark, though. Some wrestling going on there. Darryl Smith eventually gets possession. A good kick, too, up towards the open spaces there across the half-forward line. Players slipping there a little, but leading in the race to the ball is Michael Bennett. What a fine player he is, but there's the slip on again. It looks as though it might be a little bit dewy and wet out there tonight, Bucky, with that little bit of slipping there by the players.
Yes, conditions apart from that are excellent, Brenton, and we should see players. Well, they've bounced the ball so far. We've seen both Naylor and Slattery bouncing the ball on this surface, so it can't be too bad at this stage.
Well, an opportunity here for Sturt through Peter Motley, gets the handball out, but straight to a South Adelaide opponent. He's pushed in the back, and so South momentarily out of trouble there on that in that back pocket area. And the clearing kick underway, out of sight of the ground. That was from Fairclough. Out wide, nearly out to the boundary line. It's pushed out even wider. Kapler picks it up brilliantly, gets the left foot kick down towards the half forward line, but there it rolls out of bounds. So we'll see a throw in there. With the score, South 1-1, Sturt one solitary point.
Well, if Chris Radbone and Darren Kapler get a chance to show their speed out on that wing, we'll see some grass scorched. The throw in. Tap away by McKechnie. And again, it's Craig working to get out of trouble. Eludes the tackle of Michael Irvine, goes in short. McKechnie makes a mess of it. Gets out of it now. Finds Spiel. Centre wing. Stirred into attack towards centre half forward. Benson from behind takes the mark, and he's some 45 to 50 metres from goal. Sturt moved the ball quickly into their forward line, and maybe one more quick kick was in order because he's just out of distance for mine. Gives it a good try. Oh, lots of pushing underneath the ball, and the umpire must have been satisfied. And off hands behind the result. Second for Sturt, and they trailed by 5 points. South 1-1, Sturt 2 points only.
The kick in, good one too. Towards the centre of the ground there, the spoilers on from Sturt, but taken by Irvine. The handball over to Kapler, and as Ted says, plenty of pace in this player's legs. The left foot kicked down towards centre half forward over the top of Butler's head. It goes, two South players, now two Sturt players in there. The handball from Butler, can't find his teammate there. Stacks on the mill. Handballed out again. And now South Adelaide with an opportunity to score. Teddy, was it through John Dawkins? It was. And so South Adelaide bring up their second goal. Plenty of perseverance there. And they move along to 2-1, Sturt 2 points.
Well, that was the key word, Brendan, perseverance. And Shane Butler was the player who persevered on the ground with the ball for a couple of seconds before he got the handball out to Dawkins. Dawkins lined up and straight through the centre, but really it was Butler's work that scored that goal. He worked on the ground very, very hard to keep the ball in possession and eventually got that handball out, a low one.
And McKechnie and ruck still for Sturt.
That's Christie. About the best draw I've seen from a ruck hit out.
Beautiful dead heat. But the ball work now up towards the centre half forward area for Sturt. Player's not handling it cleanly at the moment. Wilson tries to get the handball out, but I think the umpire is going to indicate that it was a throw. He does. And so Kapler again with the ball. Gets the play moving pretty quickly. Looking for Snee Bickler at centre half forward. The handball smothered. That was well done by McPhee. Gains possession now. The kick underway is to the outer side of the ground. Open spaces where Craig is led. No one can mark it. A chance here for Barbary showing plenty of pace. The handball is across to Radbone. He's on the natural left foot there to bring it back towards the full forward spot. Players up. Off hands it goes. But it's South Adelaide who will relieve out of that back line area to the outer, to the grandstand side of the ground where the ball now rolls out of bounds. So we'll see a throw in there. We've played nearly 12 minutes of this first quarter. The throw in, Motley, the only Sturt player there to take the knock. And so it's South Adelaide with the ball on the half-back line. Bennett through Michael Bennett up towards their half-forward line. But again, a good spoil from the Sturt defenders. And so we'll see another throw in, centre wing, grandstand side of the ground.
Sneebickler's really got his job cut out tonight, Ted. He's got Spiel jumping against him and a couple of other guys as well.
Well, they know where the pressure points are, Sturt, obviously. Smith's high hand pass. Painter, out of trouble. Reverses direction. The kick a bit loose. Wilson through. Kapler was there, but he couldn't handle it either. Benson. Into the open. Smith. Put into trouble. Benson again. Loses the grip once again. Smith back on it for Sturt. Boundary line close. Hooks it high. Wilson's there. Outnumbered 2-1 and the ball over the line, and perhaps Sturt a little lucky to keep it in their forward area. Well and truly outnumbered on that half forward line. 11 points the difference and South lead. 13 minute mark first term. We'll play 21 minutes in the first and second terms. Darryl Hewitt scouts well. Darryl Smith, his counterpart from Sturt, and then towards the forward area it goes. Palmer from behind. Bennett again with the hand pass. Player well and truly grabbed there was Darrell Hewitt. He didn't have the ball, but he does now. The beneficiary of a free kick. South being first into the ball and making Sturt become tacklers and not always the right way. Oh, good mark, Snibicki. Johnny Snibicki. Got a bit of a problem here to... I think he's wearing a size 32 pair of shorts and the kick over half-board. Eddie Fry takes it offhand, back towards the centre of the ground and behind Darrell Hewitt, too clever for Benson. Stewie Palmer wearing the latest fashion in summer jumpers. The hand pass off is good. That's to Fairclough towards the forward area. Big fist away from behind was by Whittlesey, but it's Darrell Hewitt chipping in. Kick towards goal. Butler in front. Can't take the mark. Opposed by Ford. Ford hooks it back. Underneath the bottom of the pack. Umpire says somebody was held. And that's Eddie Fry on the bottom of the pack. Back pocket for Sturt. Nothing offering on the outer side. So we'll go virtually towards the grandstand flank. And there's a mark to Kapler once again. That's David Kapler, half forward flanker. Breaks away, back in towards the pocket from whence it came. Harris from behind, hits the deck. Irvine was there, got a short kick away. McPhee, the hand pass, didn't have enough oomph in it. That put Eddie Fry in trouble. The bounce down and South, only 20 metres out from goal, with a chance to goal once again. They lead 2-1 to 2 points.
Of course, Eddie Fry, former South Adelaide player, now playing with Sturt, of course. The bounce down at centre half forward, cleared by Sturt to the outer side of the ground. Radbone underneath the ball against Kapler. Whittlesey calling for the handball, but it's forward now. Whittlesey will gain possession. Does so on the half-back line. Drives the ball up towards centre half forward. Little nudge in the back there against Smith, but the mark is being given to Robin White. And along with a 15-metre penalty, after receiving a little bit of unnecessary attention there from Darrell Smith, after he had marked that ball. Robin White. Most in the centre of the ground, as you can see on your screen. A good-looking kick, too, down towards the centre-half forward spot. Again, looking for Snee Bickler. Can't win possession, but Slattery can. A good, long, high kick up towards goal. In fact, that's going to fade back and go through the goals for the South Adelaide's third goal and Slattery's second.
Yes, Wayne Slattery, again, reading the ball so well, as we've seen him so often this season, and he just read that ball off the top of the pack, and we see the line-up for goal here. We didn't see him actually read it off the pack, but the kick, of course, a powerful one from the little fellow straight through the centre. His second goal, as Brenton mentioned, and South go on to 3-1-19 to Sturt 2 solitary points.
And a pretty good opening there from South Adelaide in this first quarter. Open up a handy lead at this stage, and Christie and Ruck for them against McKechnie. Two big young men. Christie the tap, a good one too, straight down to his rover, and so South into attack again. Eddie Fry coming across the half-back line there, gets possession of the ball. But another free is going the way of South Adelaide, this time to Shane Butler. 40 metres out from goal, directly in front. And Sturt will have to be very careful, Brian, if this game's going to hold South Adelaide in check, because this could put South Adelaide four goals clear if Butler can convert. Moves in now, the kick underway, normally a very reliable kick. No exception on this occasion, so South Adelaide 4-1. Sturt, 2 points.
Yes, Butler, a goal to South Adelaide. They're kicking into whatever breeze there is here. By the appearance of the flags, it might be one or two goals. And here we see Peter Hargraves interchanging now and coming onto the ground. Sturt sorely need a lift in ruck because Christie has got a lot of knocks away from the centre bounces. So South Adelaide going to 4-1-25 to Sturt, 2 points.
Let's see the result of this one. Christie gets the favoured bounce. But Sturt moving it forward through Hutton. Palmer bursting through. Gets a hand pass to Mark Naley. The hand pass in turn is to Darrell Hewitt. Back again, this time to David Kapler. He lines up towards goal. South looking very dangerous. Harris and Reid back there with the ball offline, just the minor score. Now it's four goals clear the difference. 4-2 to South and 2 points to Sturt. Peter Reid with the kick towards the half-back flank. But again, South outnumber Sturt at the fall of the ball. And this time, the mark taken by Christie. He's just backward of the centre-half forward position. Gets some distance towards that forward line, however.
No mark taken. Fry is there. The hand pass to Craig. Out wider to McPhee. The hand pass again, Laxham. Back to Fry. Manages to get out of trouble with the left boot high from behind Benson. In front, Hewitt. Oh, throws the ball away. Stewie Palmer sees it over the line, however. Throw in centre wing, grandstand side. Hargraves for Sturt and Christie for South. Hargraves gets hands on the ball. Barbary hooks it back, but in turn Fairclough for South Adelaide. Craig working well back behind the play of the ball. Tries to get it forward. Kapler's there, working on the ground. The hand pass is good. Finds Hewitt, Darrell Hewitt. Drops it in short towards Harris. He's going to the top of it. Ford's there for Sturt. McPhee for Sturt. Chips it up in the air. Wilson's there and marks just inside the line. He's a bit more accurate with the kick than he was with the hand pass so far, young McPhee. Motley in the middle of the pack. Put the hands on to take the ride up. And no mark taken. Bounce down centre wing, grandstand side. Almost the 20-minute mark now of this first quarter. And South lead by 4 goals. Christie's tap away to Robin White. Hargraves, or just throws it out anywhere. 3 South players there. And once again, we see David Kapler break clear, driving South Adelaide into attack with his 5th kick. Goes out wide. Shane Butler spins onto the left boot. Snaps towards goal. And goal umpire says 1 point only. 4-3 South, 2 behind Sturt.
The kick in from Reid is a good one, right up towards the centre of the ground. In fact, it was a glorious kick. And Naley, though, for South Adelaide, wins possession in the centre and gets it back towards centre-half forward. South working it pretty hard, as they've done all of this quarter. They're prepared to first persevere, get in on the bottom of those packs and push it out to their teammates. And there's a classic example of it with David Fairclough winning possession. The kick is a short one, but it's going to do the job because it's fallen into the arms there of a teammate in Darren Harris. And what a very good player Darren Harris has been this season for South Adelaide.
If he gets onto that, he'll put it up under the covered part of the stand.
Yeah, or out into the golf course next door. And the siren sounds to end this first quarter here at Football Park. And Harris, with the kick, it's underway. Certainly got the distance, but the umpire moving to the left, indicating it's a minor score to South. But nevertheless, a pretty good quarter from them. 4-4 they are to Sturt 1-2. And we'll join Brian Cunningham and Max Stevens right after this break for their summary of that first quarter's play.
Welcome back to Football Park, and South Adelaide in control. Bucky, why?
Well, it seems to me, Max, that the smaller players of the South Adelaide side are the ones that are dominating at the moment. They've run the ball up into the wind very, very well. And players like Slattery and Dawkins and Naley, and in particular the Kapler brothers, have done well. Here we see a replay of the first goal of the game. Wayne Slattery reading the ball off the top of the pack so well, and takes one bounce. Beautiful play by Slattery there, and runs straight into the goal. It was a powerful kick, and there was nothing that Sturt could do about that. And that, Max, as far as I can see, is the problem with Sturt. They just haven't got the smaller players that South Adelaide have got at the moment.
On the other hand, apart from that, where do you feel Sturt are going wrong?
Well, I've not seen a Sturt side that have wasted so many handballs as they did in that first quarter. Most of their handballs were at the feet of players, and it's unusual to see Sturt not handling the ball and giving it out with precision.
Well, their coach there is keeping them in for a long time. The umpires have called them in. Do you think we've got a really good game on hand? Because they did come back the last couple of weeks, Sturt. They've got that ability.
Sturt are a good side under lights. We've seen it when they played Melbourne in a Stirling Cup match some weeks ago. And, of course, 2 weeks ago they played very well in defeating Glenelg. I think they can come back.
Well, 26 points at quarter time is a handy lead, isn't it?
It is. It's a good lead. But we'll see how good the side Sturt are from now.
Well, let's go back to Brenton Miles, and he's in the central commentary position.
Thanks, Max. And the players working their way back towards their positions for the beginning of the second quarter. And as you both mentioned, Sturt will need to certainly lift their game and get that handball working, as you say, Brian, a little more efficiently and effectively if they're going to be a good competitor or a good competitive side tonight. But still 3 quarters to go, and still anything could happen. And in ruck for the beginning of this second quarter will be Peter Hargraves for Sturt, in opposition to Christie from South Adelaide. Hargraves came on to replace McKechnie during that first quarter. Hargraves. But Christie the tap, and South Adelaide through Naley. What a brilliant player this fellow is. He gets the handball out wide, misses his teammate there in Kapler, but he's got the pace to recover, does so well. Hooks the ball back right up towards the teeth of goal there. Through from minor score, and a very promising opening few seconds there from the South Adelaide team.
Darren Kapler must be watched on that wing, Brenton, because he dives so far down into the forward lines. He kicks two or three goals a game. He's a very dangerous player.
Certainly got plenty of pace and good ball control, I agree, Brian, and it. And Ray Wilson certainly got his hands full there at centre wing for Sturt at the moment. Pushing it forward is Radbone, another racehorse. Eddie Fry, the tap back towards Radbone. Gets the handball out to Hutton. There the fumble on from John Painter, and the ball goes to ground. From behind he pushes an opponent there in Fairclough, it is, I think, in the back. And so South Adelaide with the ball at centre wing. 15-metre penalty against a Sturt player there for interference after the free had been given. And Fairclough now for South Adelaide. Driving kick too, up towards centre half forward. The spoil on from Reed, out there in the direction of Whittlesey. Irvine applies the pressure. The handball out to Painter. Another handball out to Reed, who backed it up pretty well. The hurried left foot kick back towards a teammate.
Hutton.
Hutton it is, the centreman. Up towards Peter Motley. He's been quiet in the first quarter, but didn't have a lot of opportunities. But this time the handball astray again. And so South Adelaide through McIntyre. Trying to win possession out there. Two or three Sturt players in the fall of the ball. I think it's McPhee on the outer side of the ground. The handball back to Radbone. Radbone the handball over looking for Hutton. But gee, I think you picked it, Bucky. The handball's not good from the Sturt side. Neil Craig there. Another handball astray. See if South Adelaide can perform a little better. It's over to Kapler from Naley. Kapler the racehorse underway again. Gets the kick up towards goal. But it's offline for another point to South Adelaide. Peppering the goals, 4-6 they are. Sturt 1-2.
Gee, Sturt handling the ball, or their general skill level is way down. Their fumbling and hand passing is not good to see at all. Hutton marks a kick in from Eddie Fry. A long hand pass finds Wilson. Notice they swapped wings. Ray Wilson started on this side. He's been switched onto the very quick running Darren Kapler. Motley from off the top of the pack and kicks it straight up in the air. Benson back there with Bennett. Off hands to White. Hand passes good to Fairclough, and South Adelaide on the run again. And long, deep over the half forward line. Hewitt, Darrell Hewitt, whips in the mark. Just puts out the telescoping arms. Back in towards the forward area it goes. Big pack of players. Off the hands it comes. Working it clear. Getting in there close with Slattery. High in the air. Fisted away once again. Slattery again, reads it off hands, this time with the left boot. Snaps towards goal and hits the bottom of the post. And, gee, South Adelaide just can't get the ball out of their forward line. They've got it locked up in there. 4-6 now, South, and Sturt are two behinds only. The flags hadn't completed their wave, and once again the ball will come back. Eddie Fry to do the kicking in. 4-7 South and Sturt, two behinds only. Early days so far in this second term. Once again, a long punt kick away, this time from Eddie Fry. Smith through, leaves it behind. Hutton in on top of the ball, and the umpire will be forced to bounce. Hargraves and Christie. Neither gets clear tap away. Christie. But Painter does it well. Palmer and Brown come to meet it. Palmer over the top. Motley not having one of his better nights. Just about to break away, but the umpire had blown the whistle prior to that breakaway. Bounce down between centre half forward and the centre of the ground for Sturt. Christie. Once again, it's Kapler. Darren Kapler. Abt forwards there. Gary Ford takes the mark on the chest. Almost up the centre wing. The running players from South creating havoc. Hargraves back to Ford, tries to burst his way through. Wilson for Sturt now, and into the forward line it goes. Motley in front, the fist away is good. Painter's there, quick tackle is on the deck, knocked forward by Motley. He's pushed in the back, and the free kick will go the way of Peter Motley in the right forward pocket.
Only Peter Motley's second kick tonight, Ted, and McIntyre has done a good job so far on him, but remember in the second quarter of the last game that we played, that we saw here, played against Glenelg, he dominated in the second quarter.
ball. Stop, starting to fall short. The fist away. Robin White in front. Tackle is good. Once again, it's Bennett. Gets the hand pass out well. The running, Naley. Towards the centre of the ground it goes. Somebody had the hand over the shoulder, and it's Benson from Sturt who will take the free kick. Just forward of the centre line. Jamie McPhee, rather. Just forward of the centre line.
Playing his first game and doing pretty well, too. The spoil on from McIntyre against Peter Motley brings the ball down to the ground. Pack of players forms there, and so we'll see a bounce at centre-half forward. The tap. Peter Motley actually went up for the knock then. Sure, where our ruckman are, or where the Sturt ruckman are, Ted, at this stage.
That seems to be the design. He's even taking the boundary throw-ins because there's no Rick Davies down there today.
Well, there's Motley going for the ball again at centre-half forward. And the umpire now moving in and is going to bounce the ball between centre and centre-half forward with Sturt just into attack. Motley again, but struggling there in the ruck position. Darryl Smith the ball up towards the full forward spot. The spoil is on from the south defence. Butler's got to get rid of it very quickly, but he's got three players backing him up. White's one of them, gets the ball, kicks it out wide towards centre wing. Ray Wilson's got to handball it very quickly to keep it in play. Good strong bump there from Darryl Brown. The kick off the ground to Darryl Smith. He's got the call on from Barbary. Oh. Barbary, the handball is not good. Puts the player under pressure in Hutton there playing in the centre, but Barbary's going to get out of trouble because he's going to get a free between centre and centre-half forward. Sturt, really not with a lot of method at this stage. Barbary, the kick, is wide, but all Sturt there at the moment through John Painter. But he's brought the ball very wide to the outer side of the ground. Now hooks it back towards centre-half forward, but the south defence up to it. The hurry kick falls into the arms of a Sturt player there.
Wilmot.
And that was Ian Wilmot. And what's he done? Yes, he's converted. The Sturt's first goal of the evening. They move along to 1-2, trailing South Adelaide 4-7.
Well, it was a fortunate goal. The quick kick coming out from Darryl Smith didn't really mean it for Wilmot, but he got that one and made the most of his opportunity. The ball appeared to be veering offline, but it came back a little bit in the end, so it was through for a goal. And Sturt's first goal, and, gee, they need a few more of those. 1-2, plays 4-7.
Gary Christie again in ruck for South. Gets the big thump away in front of Peter Hargraves. The ball taken away there by Snip Bickler. Out wider it goes to David Kappler. Up towards the forward line. Dawkins was there and the mark completed. It's some 35 metres out from goal. Four kicks up forward, and South Adelaide appear to be doing it on the bit at the moment. They've had 11 scoring shots to Sturt's three. John Dawkins brings the ball back into play. The big leap is from behind. Snabekla, who would normally, you'd think, he'd be up front leaping for the ball, read it well, took the easy chest mark. And what can one say when that happens, Bucky?
Well, you can't do much about it. There was only one Sturt defender up, and he really had to go with the South Adelaide player, and there should have been another defender behind backing up as Snabekla was.
John Snabekla, 5 metres out from goal. The kick on the way, no mistake, his first for the match, and South Adelaide's fifth, 5-7 to 1-2.
It really wasn't good defensive work from Sturt. The ball coming in from Dawkins, a long drop punt kick in, and we watched the big fly there, the one player, the Sturt player flew. He had to fly because there was a South player there, but there was no one blocking behind, and, gee, you don't get them any easier than that, John Snabekla. So 5-7, 37 to South Adelaide, Sturt 1-2-8.
Centre bounce once again, and again it's Gary Christie opposed to Peter Hargraves. Christie, number 32, hasn't done much wrong in that centre bounce. Hargraves tried to smother it down. Christie couldn't bring it away, but he's still working like a beaver on the bottom of that pack. And by gee, he's a workhorse, isn't he? Glorious youth. Again, the bounce, a few more players around at this time. Peter Hargraves tries to use block with his body, but Christie was good enough. Tapped forward by Russell Hutton, was it? No, it's Whittleseed to take the kick. He was grabbed too high. Barbary's there and directs play into the left forward pocket. Motley's out there, off hands. Bennett for South Adelaide, out of the open space. Give the running Hewitt the chance. He's quickly tackled, however. The kick off the ground has been marked by Chris Radbone. A lot of people in the crowd didn't agree that that went 10 metres. Towards the half-forward line, Wilmot couldn't complete the mark. The ball on the deck, White trying to break away, ruled that he was tackled too hard. He'll get a free kick, and he's almost to the centre-half back position as he takes it. Keeps the ball going around the outer flank this time. And a mark taken in the middle of the pack, Johnson a victim. The long hand pass, look for the run of the players, finds Shane Butler, in short it goes. Eddie Fry's there, oh, wild and woolly kick off the ground. This allows Slattery to get the hand pass across towards Irvine. Once again up into the forward line. The bounce of the ball, we'll see it go through. No, it won't. Carried across the line with a desperate dive there by Peter Reid. And another behind to South Adelaide. They're eight. 5-8 now, South. Leading Sturt, 1-2, 10.5 minutes of the second term gone.
The kick in, grandstand side of the ground, looking for Hargraves, but Christie doing it well in ruck for South Adelaide tonight. Fists it clear of Hargraves' hands, and so the ball out of bounds on the half-forward line. Christie versus Hargraves. Body work there. Christie again, hands to the ball, down the direction of Hutton for Sturt, but he can't gain possession, so we'll see a bounce. Played 10 minutes of the second quarter, and South Adelaide a very useful lead. 5-8 to Sturt, 1-2 at this stage. Hargraves gets the tap, gets a good handball away, this time to Ray Wilson. Ray Wilson towards the centre of the ground. Good ball control there by Kapler. Got Fairclough running past. He's put him under a bit of pressure because he was running the wrong way. The kick back towards centre wing, and Peter Motley juggles it, does it well, and Peter Motley showing a little bit of useful aggression there, and that's really what a few more of the Sturt players need to do at this point in the game. The kick down towards the half-forward line there. Benson in hard for Sturt. Very promising young player, Matthew Benson, and gets the free for in the back.
McKechnie's just replaced Hargraves in ruck.
Right, into the fray, and so the ball across to centre half-forward from Benson. A good kick, but South Adelaide are going to clear it out of that defensive action out towards centre wing. Eddie Fry moves through, does it well, but then has the kick brilliantly smothered. The kick off the ground from Slattery. Players falling over there, including Irvine. Back to Eddie Fry as it goes. He's tackled high, I think. Yes, he is. And umpire Kinnear, I think he might have ducked. Ted, Brian, how do you see it?
Hard to say with that one. I don't know. It's Eddie Fry's sixth kick coming up. He's played quite well at half-back.
As he did a fortnight ago. Eddie Fry, the kick. Long driving kick looking for the leading Wilmot, but it's over the head of those players. Peter Motley with another opportunity, working hard. The ball pushed towards the boundary line and it'll roll over. McIntyre in pursuit there for South Adelaide. We'll see a throw in the Sturt forward lines. It looks like Peter Motley is going to be called upon to do a bit of rucking work in that forward line area. Gets the fist to ball, but not to a teammate. The kick underway from South Adelaide, again out of bounds, and Kapler, you see they're handling the ball back to the boundary umpire. Sturt runner nearly in the road there. The throw in now, McKechnie. The tap down to Painter, couldn't take possession. A chance for Craig, working hard over to Ray Wilson. He's immediately tackled. And the handball a little bit astray tonight there from the Sturt side, and Robin White has been freed there. And he'll relieve for South Adelaide on that half-back line. The lead from Schnee Bickler, but Spiel right with him. Those two players will contest. Waiting at the back there is Jeff Leonard, who's come onto the ground. Immediately gets a good handball away over to Ray Wilson. Wilson kicking up towards Painter there. Wilmot it was. And it's Neil Craig for Sturt who forces the ball over the line. So we'll see yet another throw-in. Plenty of boundary line football tonight. Players keeping it wide as they move the ball down into the forward lines. Peter Motley tapping over the back looking for Leonard. Leonard applies the tackle, holds the ball in the area. Painter, a hurry kick, but it's going to fall right into the hands of Stuart Palmer, lurking in the back pocket area.
Palmer to Brooksby was a certain play, and then in effect, then on to Hewitt. Glenn Hewitt's kick. Cover centre towards half forward. Fry tried to get front position. He was interfered with on the way through and gets a free kick. No, is it Fry to take the kick? No, it's not. It's Gary Ford. Yes, Gary Ford. Chips in towards the centre, but Schnabickler read that, and Sturt's skill level is just about zero at the moment. Schnabickler's long kick in toward the lead of Harris. Good fist away by Reid. Christie dispossessed of the ball. The hand pass from McPhee finds Painter. Wilson in close, and then the long kick in towards the pocket, getting underneath it, Motley to take the mark. And Sturt looked just that much better with three hand passes, Brian, that found the body, and all of a sudden they're in attack.
That's the difference, isn't it? If you get the ball up there where it's easy to grab, you don't put players under pressure, and the result, Peter Motley about 45 metres out with his fourth kick.
Gets the kick on the way. It looks pretty good off the boot. And Sturt just looking that much better then with their second goal. Sturt 2-2, trailing South 5-8.
It was a good effort from Peter Motley to score that goal. It was a fair way out. Just having a look at that movement from the Sturt player, the quick kick coming in. Motley found plenty of space at centre-half forward. He hasn't had a lot of space so far in this game, and took an easy chest mark in the end there, but with a pretty strong kick, scored Sturt's second goal. They go to 2-2 to South Adelaide 5-8.
Centre again. McKechnie gets the tap away this time. Follows up on it. The quick hand pass off to Radbone. Radbone within kicking distance now. Blazes towards the goal square. Brooksby back there. So was Wilmot. Off hands it goes. Brown with a hand pass out. Leonard straight into trouble. South defence tight. But the ball runs loose. Smith is there. Tries to get the hand pass away. He can't. He's beset upon by three South players, and weight of numbers tells. Hewitt with a long kick out wide, and the mark taken out there by Christie. Corns about to take, Graham Corns, coach of the South Adelaide side, about to take the ground. Christie's kick is over centre. Big ride up, and the mark taken by Gary Ford. The quick breakaway, the hand pass finds Russell Hutton. Kicks off at the one leg without a pace. From behind, Wilson brings it to ground. Smith taps it on. From just forward of the centre, out towards the lead of Wilmot and Motley. Behind, it's the South defence that go to ground. Brown's there. He'll quickly be tackled there by Irvine. Ruled that he was pushed in the back. And he gets a free kick from some 45 metres out from goal, but tight on the boundary line. His first kick for the match.
Deep in the forward pocket area, Brown brings the ball back towards centre-half forward. Motley's going to fly from behind over the pack. It goes to kick off the ground, and Sturt, Jeff Lennon, and it's about his third touch since he's come onto the ground only a couple of minutes ago, scores Sturt's third goal, 3-2, South Adelaide 5-8.
Well, Ryan, that's better from the Sturt team. Well read over the top of the pack by Jeff Leonard. The dive there from Michael Bennett just couldn't stop that ball from going through for a goal. And Sturt players need to do that. They need to read the ball better off hands, because it's the South Adelaide smaller players who are winning the game.
Sturt seems to have lifted a little in the last 5 minutes of this quarter. The tap underway, the kick off the ground. Sturt with an opportunity here with the handball. Straight to Butler. Butler, the handball out to Snee Bickler, playing pretty well at centre-half forward. The kick up towards captain coach Graham Corns there. Can't take the mark, though. And it's forced over the line for a throw-in in the South Adelaide forward pocket area. Frank Spill will move in from centre-half back and take this throw-in. Looks like Graham Corns will fly with him. They're the two players you see in your screen battling for that one. Spill the fist to it, but it's over to Naylor. He's immediately tackled. South Adelaide trying to work it clear. McPhee's got a kick across goals, but at least it's out into the open. The two South Adelaide players leading in the race to the ball there. One of them's Kapler, gets possession. Onto the right foot it goes. A good kick, considering he's a left footer. And very, very close to the boundary line. In fact, it's over the line. Adjacent there to the South Adelaide point post. And we'll see a throw-in. Steve Bickler in front. Spill from behind, very, very close to the boundary line again. Corns comes in, tackled by Craig, and in fact, I think is going to lose the ball to Craig, is he? Yes, he is. The umpire indicating he didn't really make a concerted effort to get rid of the ball.
18 points the difference, South Adelaide lead.
With Craig in the back pocket for Sturt. Goes long, outer side of the ground, fisted over the back there, but two South Adelaide players lurking. Butler over to Fairclough. Good teamwork from the South Adelaide players. In towards centre-half forward, a great Dawn Mark almost taken there, but play on calls the umpire. Ray Wilson showing plenty of pace. Onto the left foot it goes, but the kick astray, dropped by Butler. Motley a little late on the scene there to arrest the passage of play there. Kapler onto the left foot it goes, playing a great game out there on the centre wing, up towards centre half forward, and a good mark.
Nope.
No, pushing going the other way, pushing the back, and the free to be taken by big Frank Spiel.
Spiel with a hand pass back to Fry, gained absolutely nothing. The ball up towards centre wing, and Butler must think it's his birthday because the Sturt players keep kicking it to him, Bucky.
Yes, he's playing well behind the game behind the play. That's his sixth kick coming up to the 19 and a half minute, 20 minute mark of this second quarter.
Five hand passes as well, so he's had plenty of touches, and we're at the 20-minute mark almost of the second term. Corns tap away off the hands of the pack. Irvine's kicking towards goal. Harris out in front, can't complete the mark. The snap back towards goal, offline. 1 point only the result. 5 goals, 9 South Adelaide, 3-2 Sturt. Sturt a bit more direct at the ball, Bucky, in the last 10 minutes or so.
Yes, I think they've improved, Ted. I think that the last 5 minutes have been a lot better from the Sturt team. South Adelaide appear to have lost a little bit of impetus.
In towards the forward area again for South. McPhee's there. Has the pace to break clear from Dawkins. Out comes Radbone. He's got the pace to break away now. Kepler hot in pursuit. Radbone's kick down the wing area, but Stewie Palmer reads it well and marks on the chest. He's at half-back flank as he takes the kick. Only half a minute or so to go in this game in the second term. The ball on the ground. The break clear is good. Leonard again. Gets the ball up towards the forward area. Motley reads it well. The hand pass is good towards Brown. He makes a mess of it. White is there. Brown loses the ball. The ball on the deck. The siren sounds. South Adelaide leading at halftime in this Escort Cup Grand Final. 5 goals, 9:39. The Sturt, 3 goals, 2:20. And we'll be back right after this break, and we'll join Brian Cunningham and Max Stevens again for their summary on that second quarter of play.
Again, welcome back to Football Park, and South Adelaide still in command, but Bucky Sturt started to show a bit of momentum then. They're getting the ball out of the centre. But well,
that's important, Max, getting the ball out of the centre, and they did a little bit more in that latter part of that quarter, but the trouble is that Christie is getting so many knocks at the centre. He's setting it up for the South smaller players. We mentioned that at quarter time, that it's the smaller running players of South Adelaide who are doing the job in getting the ball forward, and that's why South Adelaide are in front. And a lot of that is due to Christie's work in the centre. McKechnie and Hargraves at the moment just can't go with him.
Looking at the two back lines, the South back line, more so with Robin White, is teaming together, where the Sturt back line is sort of all over the place.
Well, that's right, Max. We know that the South Adelaide back line, or it is reputed that the South Adelaide back line, are the best back line in the league, and they're showing it again tonight. They work so cohesively together. They know what their movements are, and they just move the ball crisscross across the goals. They do anything to get the ball out of that area, and they often succeed with it. So they're doing a great job. And the Sturt back line, of course, we've mentioned the handball before at the feet of Sturt players. It did improve a little bit in that quarter, I thought.
Well, Sturt in general, in my opinion, are putting their own players under pressure.
We see the Sturt players reading the ball off the pack a lot better in this second quarter. We see Jeff Leonard here scoring a goal off the pack, and that's what the Sturt players have to do. The smaller players in particular have got to read the ball off the hand. If they're losing the ruck to Christie in the centre, they've got to get there and they've got to read the ball off his hand. It's a hard job to do, but they must do it if they're going to get back in the game.
And talking of reading packs, that mark of Johnny Schneebicklis down on the forward line.
Well, that's just another example where the defence of Sturt is fairly shoddy at the moment, yes.
Brian, during the past couple of months, more so this season, I think umpires have come under quite a bit of criticism. I've heard you talking on 5DN about them with Rick Davies. Do you think they're getting a rough trot at the moment?
Oh, they are. I'm not saying it. When you say we talk on 5DN about it, we don't criticise umpires necessarily.
No.
They probably are getting a fairly rough go of it this year. And I think that's only going to improve the standard of umpires. I think that what we're mainly concerned about is something like a bounce. An umpire, to bounce the ball properly, needs to practice it. And I think that's the main criticism of bouncing the ball on the football park surface. Admittedly, when it's fairly spongy and soft as it is tonight, it makes it difficult for umpires to bounce. But I think it's just a practice thing. And I think that umpires just have to work on that, as league players have to work on that parts of their game.
Well, how do you feel? Do you feel that it should be bounced or it should be thrown up?
No, I like the bounce. I think it adds atmosphere to the game. There's nothing better than starting off a grand final with a bounce in the centre and seeing an umpire get the ball up 15 or 20 feet in the air. I think that's great.
Right. Well, during the last couple of days, we sent Jackie Drewer over to Melbourne, amongst other things, just to have a look at the surface at VFL Park and also the plate they put in there. And Jackie has put this report together.
Throughout all the Escort Cup games and the minor round matches to date, one thing's remained constant, and that's the never-ending barrage of criticism levelled at the umpires. Most of it's unwarranted, but on the subject of incompetent bouncing of the ball, even the umpires have conceded some of them have a problem.
We've only had one or two who are down on that and who must improve it, and in fact will not umpire league football until they do. But the guys that are in league at present are all capable bouncers of the ball.
Last month, the SANFL considered a motion to abandon bouncing in favour of throwing the ball up, but it's been rejected.
Well, bouncing the ball, Jackie, is a skill of umpiring, and I think it would be a shame if we changed the law of the game and got rid of that skill to offset some lack of expertise, if you like, on behalf of one or two umpires. I think it's up to the umpiring fraternity to improve the skill so that there's no need to have any change at all.
Players pack up, and this time the umpire will bounce down once again.
One of those who believe it should be changed is former umpire Max Hall.
I think they should throw it up. I've always felt that. Those that say that they shouldn't throw it up say there's the glorious uncertainty of the bounce. I could do without the glorious uncertainty. I've seen umpires in the last couple of years that can't bounce, and it doesn't help the game. And throw the ball up. Let the ruckman have a good look at it instead of it skidding off at about head height.
An alternative solution is to adopt the VFL practice of inserting a metal or concrete plate in the ground to at least guarantee the centre bounce will be a good bounce.
As a matter of fact, there is one at Football Park, although it's too small, but it's better than nothing. And the directors have resolved to ask all councils, all clubs, to put a plate in their grounds. But there's a little trouble there because they've all got cricket pitches, of course, and they don't want to dig up their cricket pitch to put a plate in. But it does definitely help the bouncing situation.
But no matter what the issue, the rubbishing of the umpire looks as though it's here to stay.
It happened back in my time. In fact, the press in those days were more vitriolic than they are today. I can remember one commentator saying about myself that I suffered from myopia. He said, Max Hall can't see things that happen right under his nose, but he can see with wonderful clarity 300 yards away when he's that far behind. So, and I can remember them tipping over poor old the late Johnny Quinn's car on the Norwood Parade, tipping it upside down. I remember a game at Alberton one day when they threw bricks and rocks at me on the ground, and we used to have to come off through the crowd. That was a frightening experience.
Well, so it's not a new thing, is it here to stay?
I think it's here to stay, and in fact I think there is less criticism of the umpires by the public than there was in my time.
And this time the umpire will bounce down once again.
Well, my view is let the umpires worry about the bouncing and let the players worry about the football. 39 points here at half time, and of course, with it being grand final night, right after this break, the 5KA boys, Baz and Pilko, with some footy rumours.